Africa TV, Freak Up Studio, live. LG Ultra Gear and Hot 6, 2021, GSL Season 1.
We are officially in the first season of the GSL Code S. We wrapped up GSL Code A. Here we are now in the round of 16. It's good to be back.
Yeah, and
even though you guys are here with us just a week ago, good to be in the Code S part.
Yes, that's right. So we're just gonna play some really loud music here for a moment.
Happy birthday, Artosis!
Yeah, it's my birthday tomorrow.
Look at that, Artosis. You don't watch your loud music, Artosis?
I was.
Is that because you're so old? Because it's your birthday?
Yes, I am a boomer.
How old are you now?
Well, it's my birthday tomorrow. Thank you so much.
How old are you tomorrow?
38.
38?
38.
Boomerlicious.
Boomerlicious,
you've got a year on me.
I do. You're a youngin'.
And I'll never catch up.
Well, if I die before you, you sure will.
You'll still technically be older. But you'll just be a dead person.
Honestly, the odds of that.
And if you die before me and I outlive past that, I beat you even more, right? Congratulations on being 38, Artosis.
Yeah, thank you.
You got any plans for your birthday?
Oh, I mean, it's every day of my life is exactly the same as the day before, Tasteless.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get woken up probably right before 6 with my kids wanting to get out of bed.
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell them to go back to bed, but then I'm not going to be able to fall back asleep. So that's going to be grand.
That sounds exciting.
I'm going to lay on the couch tired as hell.
Yeah.
And for about an hour telling them to go back to bed. And then I'll stream and lose to a bunch of bad Protoss players while cussing.
Okay. That sounds really.
Yeah, and then
like
I'll play with the kids
day.
When they get home from school, and then eat dinner and go to bed.
Well, do say hi to Artosis on his birthday stream, guys, tomorrow. And just to our tournament here again, exciting to see it's 5-6-6 race distribution ratio.
Yeah,
can't get more even than that.
Always amazing.
Unless it's the round of 15.
Here's our groups, guys. Today doing Group A. Does one of these stand out as the group of death for you? For me, I got to look at C. I think C is not as deathy as normal, but...
Well, I don't think we really have a group of death. Let's just put it like that. That might be the toughest group, but people like to throw these terms around, like, which one is actually the unbelievably hardest one?
It's
like,
the bonjour?
It's not. Is there a bonjour? Is there any bonjour out there?
Will there ever be another third bonjour? Anyways, Group A. That's what we're doing here today, Taysom.
That's right.
And, of course, TY, the dominator of GSL as of late, has made this wonderful group.
Yeah.
It looks like a group that is almost impossible for him not to get out of.
I think he's going to get out easily. I think DRG probably gets out as well. Quick video, guys, then we'll start our games.
선수 교환권을 가진 선택. 선수와 좀 이야기 나눠보도록 하겠습니다.
우승하기 위해서 일단 8강을 가는 게 중요하기 때문에 승수를 조금 생각하고 있긴 한데
네.
일단 한 5명 정도가 저한테 얘기를 이미 했기 때문에
네. A조가 지금 굉장히 매력적인 조로 지금 자리매김하는 것 같은데요. 내가 A조에 가길 바라는 선수 있습니까? 한 번에 기회를 드리겠습니다. 이재선. 저 마이크.
태양 형이 갈 땐 가더라도 우승컵 하나 필요하다 그랬는데 재물이 딱 제가 알 맞는 것 같아가지고 저를 딱 뽑고
내가 스스로 재물이 되겠다.
네네.
와.
일단 방금 이재선 선수의 말은 너무 가식적이었고
오.
모두가 공감하듯 태양 형이 1등이라 생각하고 있고요. 지금 손잡고 두 명의 테란이 올라가는 그 그림을 같이 그려보고 싶습니다.
처음부터 A조 가고 싶었고요.
우와.
그래서 뭐 뽑아준다면 다 합의한 대로 가게 될 것 같아요.
네.
작년에 A조의 은총을 받아가지고 실력에 맞지 않는 거품 같은 성격을 낸 것 같아가지고 이번에도 좀 그 거품 목욕을 좀 해보고 싶어요.
마음의 결정 하셨습니까?
네.
네. 첫 번째 A조의 선수를 지목해 주시기 바라겠습니다. 누구예요? 진짜. 자, 여기서 선택 허리케인이네요.
이게 뭔가 뭐 반할 생각 없이.
네.
라운드 16. TY. Bunny. Hurricane. DRG. GSL Season 1. Code S.
All right. Here you have it. The group selection. TY getting the group that he wants. And it looks like he's going to be good going forward here, man. Like, him against
yeah.
Bunny. I just can't see Bunny beating my own. I couldn't see Bunny beating stats either. But I think TBT, it's a little bit harder to cheese your way through.
Yeah, not just that. I mean, TY is so good at the positional play. I think Bunny's shown that he's got some very strong early game. Yeah, I mean, it's one of these matchups where it's hard to envision a Bunny victory here, especially in a best of three. I mean, maybe he pulls a fast one somehow. I don't know, but I think this might be the most straightforward of all of our matches here, maybe even in Code S for round of 16.
Yeah, TY, there's a reason he picked Bunny, right? Like, Bunny is one of these borderline guys where it's like, if he's not in the round of 16, you don't go, where is he? And TY is the best TBTer ever by far. Like,
yeah.
Maru beat him in the final!
I know, right?
Yeah. I hear you, guy in the chat. That's really cool. It's really cool that you remember that did occur.
Artosis was like Professor X feeling something inside the universe. 1,000 guys in the chat screamed out at once.
Yeah, in unison.
Yeah.
Like, we saw a result that makes us think different. Listen, TY's
the best. They all said
it
once, why don't you make ghosts, Artosis? And he went, oh! All right, we're going to go to Death Aura for map one. TY versus Bunny to start our night off here. It's good to have Code S back. I hope you guys enjoyed the small Code A section of our tournament. I like that we spiced it up here. But now we're back to the classic GSL Code S group format here with Code A. And our map is loaded up. So let's get this TVT going. Bunny versus TY.
2021, GSL Season 1. We stood at the edge of the
So we're skipping player intros here. We're going to have the SCV come out immediately. And he's kind of making this C line move.
The C line? Not a B line, but a C line?
This is like a C-shaped one. Why do they call it a B line? Is that just is it the direction a B goes directly back to the hive? Where does that actually come from?
Yeah,
because I was thinking
that's
a C-shaped.
Correct.
Okay.
Like a B would fly direct. It's like, also there's another saying, like, as the crow flies.
Yeah.
Right? Which is like a direct line to something.
Okay.
It's like, how far is this from that? It's like, well, as the crow flies, it's 1 mile, but to get there on foot, it might be 2 miles.
I say,
right?
Thank you, farmer.
Everyone says as the crow flies, man.
Nobody says as the crow flies.
I just Snapchatted my homie as the crow flies earlier, actually, Tasteless. It was totally lit.
As the crow flies. I feel like I know the phrase. I've never heard anybody say it.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Huh. You never
because I don't know it, I have to mock it, Artosis. That's the kind of person I am.
Oh,
I go, oh, it's different for me. Let's make fun of it.
That's the right way to
That's
act.
The only way to live.
Yeah.
So we have a barracks planted out in the middle of the map, and there's a factory. I think it's being made in the main. I was looking on the mini map. Yeah, I'm sorry. It is being made in the main here.
But the place is SCV is hidden. Maybe we'll see a starport down there?
Yeah, it seems like he wants to hide something, and the only logical building that could come next would be a starport. Mm.
Now, Concussive Shell Marauder. That's kind of interesting, isn't it? This is not a fast command center from Bunny, so maybe going to be a build that's a little bit better against what TY is doing, I'm guessing. Right, because he's going to be able to make a few more units. Now, he does not scout the barracks as of yet. If that Concussive Shell finishes, there's a good chance that he just snipes their Reaper immediately.
Yeah, this is pretty big. Yeah, think about the Concussive Shell build, and we've seen this done to Protosses as well. The builds are slightly different, but basically, if you catch them off guard, and keep in mind, you know, things in StarCraft 2 happen faster than any other RTS game. If you manage to get the first hit off, you know, they're in quicksand as far as the fight goes. They'll be picked off inevitably. But the two units do get away. The SCV is, of course, killed over by the command center. The bunker's going to be at about 40% completion, and we're going to see a fight over here now.
Yeah, targets on the SCV that's making the bunker, which is probably a really good idea right there. Now does target down one of the Reapers immediately. Some good micro here from Bunny, I think. But TY's build is just, I mean, his units are so much better right now.
Yeah, and he's going to force a cancel on the command center. This is pretty big. Yeah, the SCVs really can't fight when the third Marauder gets down there. That's where the exchanges go much more favorably for the Marauders. So he's forced to cancel. He slowed him down. Behind this, we have TY already making another command center. And there is no other command center being made here. I got to fix our monitor here. This thing is pointed so far down. Okay, this is much better. There's no command center being made here. And the pressure's really on here because, first of all, we have Bunny. He needs to fight back. But second of all, he also has to grow behind this if he does manage to fight it off. And now the two depots are going to take damage. Yeah. This is going to be a huge supply block over here for Bunny. I mean, TY dominating with his build and with his execution, to be frank.
Yeah, it's. I think the roughest part here is TY, or Bunny rather, came down the ramp and tried to fight and tried to finish the command center, lost the fight, went back up, and then canceled, right?
Yeah.
You want to know immediately if you're going to hold or if you're not, and when you make that mistake trying to hold, then that's where TY gets really far ahead. Whereas if you insta-cancel, for instance, right, and stay up your ramp and fight in that way, then suddenly TY's build is like, oh, did we actually get damage?
Yeah. So I would say already for TY, the strategy has succeeded, right? And to be honest, this is going to be even worse for Bunny here because the game from here on out is straightforward for TY. I mean, he just continues to produce, waits for either the big counterattack or the delayed expansion and you know, plays from there. But both are easier games for any player. And in this case, we have TY who is, you know, vastly more accomplished than Bunny, but let's see how the attack goes. We got two medevacs coming out on the map. We've got Hellions inbound as well.
Yeah, and I think TY did see that. He had a patrolling Hellion. It'd be very peculiar if he did not. But I think TY is just going to have enough, right? He's got three Marauders still at decent health. He's already got two siege tanks, a Viking. Oh my gosh, a Cyclone as well.
Yeah, let's see where the medevacs can land here. This Viking doesn't end up doing any damage until the drop is basically already started. So these Marines can even shoot down the Viking if they get close enough to it. And this is some real damage being dealt over here. And it's in a pretty difficult spot for TY to just engage with. TY is taking damage alongside this.
So he's going to clean up the natural pretty quickly, moving his tanks forward a little bit. Bunny trying to multitask here.
Yeah, it looks like Bunny's managed to shimmy his infantry over behind the two gases here. This is going to force a fight.
Yeah, and with the siege tanks coming up, he's actually going to get one targeted down right away. In fact, the other one, no, not quite. Auditor comes down, Bunny just GG's. Like, not a bad idea for a counterattack, but again, I think that the big mistake here for Bunny was thinking he could fight it when he could not. When you make a mistake like that, if you commit to a defense around something like a command center on low ground,
yeah,
that's why you see, like, sometimes when new builds pop up, you'll see a Terran, like, super die. Like,
oh,
remember
yeah.
when the Max Pax build came and people were trying to save the command? They would just that's it. The game ends because they're keeping that up too long. They're fighting down there. They're losing extra. You got to know when you see it and be like, oh, I can't hold this right now. Cancel that CC. Restart if that's what you're going to do on the high ground, right? And not be spending all your SCVs trying to hold.
It's pretty cool to see that, you know, there have been periods of StarCraft 2 where the early game has been fairly stale. To see new builds come out like that where you can absolutely show an opponent does have a glass jaw in their build, you know? We're going to go on to Romanticide here for map number two. TY versus Bunny continues on. TY with a 1-0 lead.
2021, GSL Season 1. We stood at the edge of the world. Seize the
stakes. Oh, dude.
Oh, my.
Okay.
What if it's exactly the same thing?
But there's sometimes some genius to doing the exact same build again in a best of three.
Yeah.
Especially one that is...
Oh, man.
Not all builds are made equally, guys, and some builds are designed to be used and then pretty much disposed of, not even for your opponent, but for the tournament and maybe even for an entire season, you know, as if you're a competitive player who's studied and watched. But obviously, in this case, we have an extremely different scenario because both players are making barracks on opposite sides of the map. And in fact, Bunny's making two. And so this is going to be one of these games where we have two builds that are engineered to punish, you know, typical play, and we're going to see how they interact. I actually don't quite know what happens with this. I feel like the red player wins.
Yes,
but
I assume that Bunny is going to get about as free a win as you could ever get, right? Because if they're
like
both
it.
Making Reapers, and TY is going up to a factory his main, like, if he had his racks in his main, he could hold this.
Yeah.
But his Reapers are going to be way out of position. He's going to have half as many. I think Bunny is going to, like, insta-win this, basically. We'll see TY struggle a little bit. He'll pull his SCVs. They'll get kited. That'll be it.
I actually don't remember. Was it Tech Lab immediately after Barracks in game one for TY,
right?
That's
right. That's
okay,
right.
Yeah. So TY is actually not doing the same build.
No. It's
oh, that was a Hellion with the build. I was like, what was the other unit that was there? Okay, yeah. Now, yeah, this looks to be among one of the more straightforward ideas in StarCraft that you could possibly have. What TY is doing is a pretty modest pressure build that he can punish. Now, keep in mind, he's going to see the Reaper. Bunny might actually think that TY also made two barracks. So this may change his behavior. I'm not sure. I just want to put that idea out there.
Yeah, I guess that is possible. I think if you go two racks, you do wait for two to go, generally. And when he sees that, yeah, he starts to go up. So you want to deny the factory from building first because, oh my god, he actually gets it finished on that first SCV. So I think he's having a hard time splitting his attention right now. I think that does give a chance, right, to TY because he's going to be able to do things like pop out a Hellion. But
yeah.
Still, I it seems like Bunny is just, this is like way too much.
Yeah.
Maybe even, like, I'm trying to figure out how you can win this. Okay, he's chasing with almost all his SCVs. He has the Hellion out. He is making another Hellion.
Okay, it's coming down. Oh my god, the damage on the Hellion's insane. Can he actually get this repaired? I'm worried a Reaper dive, and this is just not a lot you can do. Okay, he gets the kill. The Reapers haven't healed. This first Hellion might get a... Oh, hold on. He's going to pull it away. Second shot doesn't get the kill.
Yeah, this is insane damage very, very quickly. TY has made an interesting choice of making a bunker over at Bunny's base. Bunny actually has no SCVs now, right? He's got one.
Well, hold on. There's
this is turning really interesting because I think in this case, you're supposed to lift off.
Yeah.
And
it's
like
3 to
the other base,
6.
Maybe.
Well, how many minerals in the bank here? It's 100 for TY.
90
so
for Bunny.
Two SCVs for TY, one SCV for Bunny. But I guess you can land mules. These are orbitals.
Yeah, that's
just to keep
that's
in mind.
True, that's true.
Normally in StarCraft, you'd look at the supply in a base trade and count how many more workers can be made. But
uh-huh.
Okay, so where are the two barracks then that are floating for Bunny? They're still down in the bottom left. In fact, they're not floating. There's a chance that you could land the CC somewhere, land a mule, suck up some more resources, make a few more Reapers, depending on how fast you are. Mm-hmm. There are also two Marines here, which can attack the command center, which means it can't go unimpeded.
Yeah, but there's seven Reapers and a Hellion, so I think TY just dies here.
Yeah, I think Bunny wins. GG, great game.
Yeah, that was definitely a build order win for Bunny. I don't think that there was like much that could have been done there.
No,
after the builds were chosen. You know?
Some builds like this do just counter each other, and we've never casted a game like that. You know, we've never had those two builds interact. I mean, there's so many different builds in StarCraft, and Artosis and I have been doing this game for over a decade, and I haven't casted that one game yet.
That's very true.
It was interesting to see how both sides behaved. I thought TY was still being pretty smart and handling it pretty well, despite pretty much being boned. But you know, the goal for Bunny in that, once he realizes what position he's in, is to just keep enough Reapers alive that he then has the killing blow in the end. So how long has this been going on? We've been live for 21 minutes, Artosis.
Yeah.
Intro to the show, videos, two Terran games.
A happy birthday song.
A happy birthday song.
Busy beavers.
We're about to wrap this TBT up. Hopefully this game's a longer one.
2021, GSL Season 1. We stood at the edge of the world.
Africa Freaks, TY.
Team NV, Bunny.
All right, no proxy barracks this game. We're done with those shenanigans.
What are they doing? They're playing it wrong.
Yeah.
This is off meta here.
Yeah.
All the buildings inside their base? What is going on?
All right. Well, I think it's the most likely that we'll get a normal TBT now.
I've got my fingers crossed. Don't worry. So, Martosis, you know, I sleep in a little bit later than you, but the mornings that you do stream, I do sometimes pop in. I'm having my coffee, but I did pop in a Maynard stream.
Yeah.
And I caught him talking about how he was talking about us in his stream.
Oh, yeah?
He was, yeah. And I was lurking there for a little bit. I just had it on. I'm, you know, getting ready and got my morning going. He was talking about how we don't tie our own ties.
Oh, that's
this
that's,
is actually true.
That's a lie.
He's the one who can't tie his own tie.
I tie his tie at every event.
We have still not figured out how to tie ties here. We've looped them in the back of the makeup room.
Look, I've given myself.
We have little nooses that we've put over our heads before we come in here.
Take them off very carefully.
Somewhere in our careers, we decided we probably can still get away doing this without actually being able to tie a tie. And to this day.
Well, since Maynard started getting hired at StarCraft events, it's been a lot easier
to
not know how to tie a tie. But there, I remember once there was an event, like an MLG in New York, and I literally went down to the front desk. I'm like, can you tie my tie? And the front desk of a hotel. And they were like, no. I'm like, can you find someone that works here that can tie my tie?
This is a game we've been playing for a long time, is refusing to learn how to tie ties. And just
eventually they got like a bellboy or something that came up and tied my tie for me. I'm like, thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
But yeah, since Maynard came around, thanks, Maynard.
Thank you, Maynard.
Thanks for tying my tie so many times.
Because if they don't, the show's going to start. We'll just lay down on the floor until somebody comes and puts a tie around our neck.
Yeah. You know.
Yeah.
He doesn't feels the worst. So
he doesn't
like,
have to do it, by the way. He doesn't have to, but we've
but
sort
we look
of
really sad.
Yeah.
When
that's,
he
I'm like, well, then I just want we're tying this cast. People are like, oh God, all right, somebody.
But the thing I feel really terrible about is if Maynard ties it, and I think he didn't do a good enough job, and I have to ask him to retie it. That's happened a couple times, and I feel terrible.
I'm like, it's not
about
even
it,
the bottom
like,
part sticking out.
I'm like, Maynard, buddy, I love you, but.
I love you, but this is going to look silly on me. I'm going to look like a gorilla wearing a tie if it's this high up.
Yeah.
Anyways, cheers to Maynard if you're watching.
It's GSL, man. He's watching.
Yeah, he's here. He's got sound turned all the way up.
For sure.
And for everybody watching, it's good to be back doing Code S again.
Oh, I'm so
excited for the year.
Yeah, and, you know, it's a different format. It's the first time we're starting Code S in the round of 16. So that's definitely very, very different. GSL originally was a 64-man tournament for three seasons. Then it went to 32 in Code S when Code S was introduced. And then it went to 24, and now it's at 16. And maybe next year we'll be down to 8.
Yeah, dude, we're still waiting until it's just 4. GSL Code S starts in round of 4.
GSL Code S is going to be a show match between TY and Maru eventually.
Okay, Hellion drop over here. Not bad so far. I would say Bunny's doing a decent job running away here. If he can just get... Actually, this did not go well for TY, really.
It almost went amazingly, though.
Yeah.
If he had one more shot there, one more shot, Tasteless.
And TY has not moved this...
Oh, he only killed one?
I actually thought he killed more than that, to be honest. I thought it was three or four, maybe, but one is... It's actually really bad. If this was anybody but TY, I would say that this is going to be a very difficult game to win from here. But
imagine
let's
if
see.
Bunny just like eliminates him and
yeah,
like Bunny just knocks out all the people that should win GSL and then like
TY's trying to leave the studio and we look at him and go sit down and cast the rest of this day.
Yeah. Caster Park gave all TY's replays to his opponents. He's like, I don't like this curious guy. All right, little drop coming in here from Bunny. He did poke the front as well, so no units up in the main base to stop this. Forces a cancel on that depot. Oh, double Viking. Tries to get out of there, but instead just picks up and boosts over, dropping out. See how much damage he can get done. Definitely a lot more than those Hellions got done, Tase, so I'll tell you that much. Six SCVs.
Yeah. Again, things are all in place for Bunny to have a smooth game here. I'm actually excited about this because I want to see how TY plays in a position like this. Most of TY's games, honestly, he basically gets a few steps ahead right at the beginning.
Yeah.
And then, you know, it's a short boxing match from there.
Yeah, yeah. Very oftentimes.
So TY is going to come in here with a push, and this has to work doubly because of how bad his attack did. Normally, a push like this is intended to be a closer after you killed more SCVs. The reverse has happened this time around.
He's down 10 SCVs, Tasis. That is really a significant amount. All right, so TY pushing up like 3 tanks and 4 Vikings is no laughing matter.
Yeah, he might try to push and aim for infrastructure here.
This is,
if he can actually force a lift on the factory, he can probably get a tank, mounting a tank lead here. This is kind of an unusual way to win a mid-game, but this is an absolutely acceptable way to close it.
Oh my god, look at the amount of damage on that factory,
yeah,
actually.
If he's going to get that before it lands, because it can't land in between this. That's pretty huge. He needs to get an add-on on that.
Yeah, a lot of damage on it. And now he has a Liberator here as well, so he can actually, like, truly push, because that air advantage is not going to go away too quickly. I guess we do actually have 2 starports for Bunny, so popping out 3 Vikings. Does have that double Raven going across the map. You know what? Bunny really has potential to win this game still, but TY's push is fearsome. Look at this. Oh my god, auto turrets are going to just massacre.
Yeah, and they're going to need to for Bunny's sake here. This push is really putting a lot of pressure on here. It looks like the air fight should be won here by Bunny. And it, you know, in tank versus tank on 2 bases, a lot of times that's how you basically lose it, is, you know.
TY is dead, Tasteless.
TY is going to be dead. Eliminated. I'm almost casting this as if I'm just not sure who's going to take it. And that's my bias right there. But
yeah,
honestly,
it's done.
Bunny, okay.
So Bunny continues his string of upsets.
Yeah.
He needs several more upsets, though, and before
Bunsets.
I will accept him with the players he's beating.
I'll tell you what. I got to be critical of TY. Yeah, watch this. Don't proxy twice in a best of 3.
If he had 2-0'd, you'd be talking how brilliant he is. You'd
that's
be massaging
called,
his feet.
I'd be massaging his hands and his feet.
Yeah.
Artosis, that's called being a great esports caster. But you know what? Let's take this to the spin room right now.
Yeah.
That game 1 win, that was great. The game 2, I don't know. I don't think it's safer to proxy twice in a best of 3 against a player you're better than. There, I said it. Go ahead. Deal with it. We're going to have a short break. We come back our next match.